Hello, how you doing? I'm back. And guess what? I got my shirt on the right side. Y'all didn't even tell me my shirt was on. And I was wondering why it felt a little different around the neck, but anyway, still comfortable. I love this shirt. You know, for all of you ladies and gentlemen who like to save money, I don't know if you remember, but on my previous video, I gave you a heads up that Ross is having their big clearance sale. Yes, baby, everything now should be, or I've been told, is 49 cents. I haven't been down there yet, but I will be going there hopefully, probably Monday and Tuesday. Things look good on Monday. I will be back on Tuesday. And for everybody that's 55 and older, Tuesdays they're 10% off. Baby, what a bargain. If you can find something you want, hello, we can do it. But anyway, I'm just trying to get this bigger. And I'm back here, and I am going to cook my flounder that I told you about. I already defrosted it. It's right here. Got my pan right here. I'm about to fire it up and drop some oil in here. I'm just going to use some regular, some granola oil. Yeah. So I'm going to let the oil get a little hot. It's only one piece because it's only me. I'm going to drop just a little bit in there. Yep. Here's my little spoon from my Tabouli salad. Oh my gosh, that Tabouli salad was so good. I had to eat a little bit. It's very good for you. It's very good for you, honey. You know, they talk about that Mediterranean diet. That could be part of it. So I have my little plastic here on top of my cutting board. I have this little thing. Let me turn this down because I don't want it to get really hot too fast. I have cornmeal. I know some people will use that fish fry, which is very, very, very good. But I don't have it. So I'm going to go back to old school and I'm going to make my own job, please. So I'm going to put a little cornmeal. Indian head. I already know everybody's grandma and ma had some. So you put that in. Maybe like a half a cup. And then I'm going to put a quarter cup of flour. Quarter cup of flour. Maybe not even that much. I'm going to leave that. And we're going to just stir it up. So I only got one piece of fish. I don't need that much. And everybody knows that you season everything. Season it, put a little salt. Put a little pepper, put a little garlic. I have some lemon stuff, and I have some smoked paprika. Don't leave home without it. Do not do your cooking without it. I'm telling you right now. So I'm just going to sprinkle a little in. A little black pepper. Now this is garlic pepper with lemon by Brass Cuisine. Oh girl, you got to get some of this. Got a website. Go ahead on there and get you some. A friend of mine got me this. I love it. I love this. As you can see, I use quite a bit of it. She bought me some other flavors too. So that was black pepper. And now I'm going to put some garlic powder in there. Just season it up to your taste. It ain't got to be nothing special. And a little smoke of paprika. And oh yeah, I got me some wine. Yeah, darling. Now, yeah, I could have had a little wine glass, but I don't need all that. I don't need all of that. So, we got that all seasoned. The oil is warming up. It's good and warm, so I'm going to turn it down a little bit more because I'm not quite ready. So, with the fish, move this out the way. It's pretty much the same thing. I'm just going to season it up a little bit. Not very much. I love pepper, so we're going to put a lot of pepper on. And a little bit of salt. The higher, you get more coverage. Okay. I keep it in here. Now, I don't know if anybody ever used this. This is chicken of the sea, premium Alaskan salmon with just water and sea salt. You find this by your tuna. Oh my gosh, this is so good. They have yellowfin, they have tuna, and they have this one. All of them delicious. I like to do that when I'm not gonna, you know, I'm not gonna cook. So I'm gonna cut this because it's a little big. And I usually just lay it on the top, get that off. And then lay that on the top of that. So I don't put too much seasoning. So boom, then I lay it in here and I shake it all around. You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Wow, you see that? Did you see that? Did you see that? So yeah, just dropped a little in there. Make sure it was hot. Make sure you shake off the excess. And just drop it on it. There you go. And we're going to do the same thing. Now you see how I laid it on top? Both sides are covered. So that way you don't put too much in. Because we put too much salt and pepper on. Because you got pepper and salt in here and all of the good ingredients, flavors that you want in there. So there you go, you got enough. Shake off all the excess flour, but you don't want too much. Oh boy, fish is falling apart. I like this fish because it's light. All right, so then I can throw my little paper towel out, wash up the little fingers. You know, you cook, you clean. You cook, you clean. You cook, you clean. So when you finish cooking, you already finished clean. You don't have to say, oh Lord, now I got to go in there and clean up that mess. No, you do it as you go along. So yeah. Now these are the other two that go along with the pepper. And this is good. This I've used only a little bit. I don't do a lot of cooking. I really don't, but I do sprinkle this like in my beans and stuff. And this is the chicken. Like I said, very good. The spices, let me see. Salt, dehydrated garlic, spices, and dehydrated onion. Now, the reason why I didn't pick this one to use so much, because the main ingredient on this is salt. And I try to stay away from salt. So I have to be careful when I use this not to use extra salt. And this one is a lot of spices and some salt and brown sugar. So this is good, I think, probably for barbecue stuff. Yeah, but they're all good. Oh my goodness, they're all good. I'm learning to put it on probably some chicken and stuff, but yep. So back here is where I keep my flour, my cornmeal. You say, what you gonna do with this? What I'm gonna do with this, I'm gonna put this in here in these bags. This bag right here. And when I cook fish again, which will probably be Sunday, I'll use the rest of this. And then I'll throw it out. Yeah, thank you. Please, you who are cringing, go ahead and cringe and get over it. But anywho, that's how that goes. And I keep it in the fridge because, like I just finished saying, I don't cook a lot. And I don't want those little ants that crawl around in your stuff because you don't use them. So I bought that big old bag. I was baking some sweet potato pies for Thanksgiving. And I didn't have any flour. So I went to the store to get some flour. And that bag cost as much as the little tiny bag. I didn't cost maybe 20 cents more. So I said, well, you know what? I don't know, but because people in my family don't cook like they used to, you know, fried foods and all that good stuff. They just don't. So I don't know, but my niece likes to bake, so maybe if she needs some flour, I can offer her some. But I figured for a quarter more, I wish you could freeze flour. So anyway, everything's all cleaned up over here. I'm just waiting for my fish to I don't know what I'm doing, child, do you? Don't ask me what I'm doing, because I can't tell you. So my fish is coming along quite good. Let me put you back up here. Everybody's getting a better chance of seeing it. So, not ready yet. You saw how easy that was to break out. And see, I can't move it. That's how you know things ain't ready. When it's still stuck to the pan, it ain't ready. Because when it's ready, it releases. It's like, okay, go ahead, do what you gotta do. I'm ready. This is some nice wine. It's called Poppy. Now, drink at your own risk. You must be 21 in New Jersey. If you can't go in a liquor store and buy it, you ain't got no business drinking it, whether you're young or old. So there you go. Leave that alone. Yes, sir. So let's see what we got. Whoa, I don't know what I'm doing. Whoa. Girl laughing, man. I told y'all I don't care. Now they're moving. Now you do. All right, I messed that up. But it's still good. It's still good. Now. So, I still have my avocado while that's finishing up. Turn that back down. I'm going to cut it. Get it ready. Oh, I'm going to get this ready, baby. It's about to go down. Oh, yeah. Look at that. Woo-hoo. Look at that. I love avocado. Yeah, let me tell you. I could just eat an avocado. It's easy. Just cut it and eat it. Give me a little salt. And that's what I could do here. Cut it and eat it. So I'm going to get this out of here. I know there's an easier way, but I didn't do it. But here, good job. I'm just going to cut it up. Give me that. Oh, Let me just put that on the paper. Turn it off. Stuff up some of that rooster poo. Put that off the fire. Get my little salty poo. City or at some point overnight, and even some single zips to the northwest. Now, that's it. A little teeny bit of salt. Yeah, baby. Starting in the city, probably close to so, boom. I love a bowl. To the west and southwest of the area. I love a bowl. I got plates. I got cute little plates too, but. I love a bowl. I don't know. I just do. Because nothing falls out of it. So I'm going to put some of my good Tabouli. Woo! Did y'all make y'all's? Yeah. Girl. Y'all better go ahead. Because y'all don't know what you're missing. Y'all don't have a clue what you're missing. Yeah, baby. I'm gonna stop being so greedy here. I can really say somebody a minute and ate up my bag. Oh, sugar, come on. Oh, y'all wanna see? Ooh, y'all be like, what you doing, girl? What you doing? Okay, here's my avocado. All right now. Still cold Tuesday. Put that like that there. And I got my fish. Take my little fish. Put it right this here. Looky, looky, looky. Looky, looky, looky. Okay. Dinner is served. Yeah. Yeah, I come with that salt one more time. Ooh. Gotta put a little salt on the avocado, I'm gonna tell you. I gotta have a little salt on it. I can't eat it just like that. That's something. But. There you go. My last glass of wine. And baby, it's about to go down. I hope you all enjoyed my dinner for tonight. My Tabouli, onions, tomatoes, and garlic, lemon juice, salt and pepper, and avocado. And avocado and sunflower seed oil, sunflower oil, with a little avocado here and fried flour. Y'all already know I love this. Mm-hmm. Oh my gosh. Mm. I don't know why I'm asking all people. You know I got to dig in. Hundreds of new models, cruisers, yachts, center consoles, sport and fishing boats. And my fish. Look at that. Electronics and accessories. You hear the crunch. Shop, compare, and save. It's the best place to see and buy boats. Girl. That is so delicious. I want to thank you all for joining with me. And remember, we're going to have that discussion. Why can't we all just get along? That's going to be a good discussion because we're going into 2020. We're about to go into get into something and you know what's supposed to happen. And we need to talk because I think we all need to be on the same page so that maybe we can understand one another a little bit better and make things happen the way they should happen. Because I know there's a lot of good people out there. As far as black and white are concerned, I believe that there's more people out here who want to get along than not. But you know,
As the world, especially Americans, stopped wearing waistcoats in the 1900s.
Girl, let's just talk. Let's just talk. I can't talk. You know why I can't talk? Because my mind is on this food right here. So don't be surprised when I come back later on tonight. Don't be surprised. And if I come back here later on tonight, we're going to be talking about it, okay? All right. Bye now. Till later. Why can't we all just get along? Tell me why. Just tell me why. Can you tell me why? You right there.